That's interesting. It would be nice to have like a higher vantage point to see it from
that we can go up.
Yeah.
So the best would be that this sculpture is we can climb on it also. But I don't think that's that's meant.
But maybe that's also part of it, that you can never see the whole of it. That's why you can't get up.
No godlike point of view, Teresa. Yeah. Even Katharina cannot überblicken, how you say.
There's no overview even for the artist.
As an artist, how does she do it? Where did she start? How did she make this thing, you know? It must be, I know it's quite physical, the way she's doing it. You feel somehow also the labor in it or something.
But that's true. That's an interesting idea, to work without knowing the end point, you know, that you, and like, yeah, the not knowing where it started and finished. And that's a really,
well, I guess it's like that. Do we know for sure? Does she make a drawing beforehand? Do we know?
I don't know, but I can't imagine that.
Neither, but.
I mean, there must be some vision, but then there must be a lot of sort of extemporizing.
Yes.
It's interesting, you don't really know whether it's heavy or light.
So I would like to touch it.
Yeah, I would like to touch it, but I took a closer look.
Allowed.
It's still rapport.
But of course, it looks like a landscape, right? Like a kind of a stone.
But like a crafted landscape.
Yes, really totally. But where's a lot of water or ice has gone through it. Or glacier, thank you. Yeah. Yes.
It's a woman who made this. And imagining all the energy in creating this,
we know it's Katharina.
Yeah, we even know.
But I mean, the fact that it's a woman who's made this, is it, what do we think about that? Does it do something? I think, because it's so big.
I know, I think that's what I always love, that kind of daring of taking up space.
Yeah.
And then always more space than you're given, because, you know,
it's
this isn't enough, I might go outside. I need a bit more room.
That's
and
great.
To claim it,
it's true.
To claim it
it's
like
true.
That.
Yes.
That's always been very exciting to me, that daring.
We can take some of that.
I know, you know, I mean, you're absolutely right, Teresa, that this is, it's not a cross-section of the Earth's crust, and it's not a glacier, but that nevertheless one seeks references.
For me, actually, the man-made or woman-made character stands out a lot. Uh-huh. So
nothing organic, let's say.
I mean, yes, the forms are, but because of the, maybe also because of the material, there are her other works where you have wood and like actual trees. Mm-hmm. But here, the form is organic, but there is something so artificial and made about it.
It's a performative sculpture, people. Yeah. So I'm not for nothing coming from the performing arts. So it's kind of something that you could, I could imagine if it would be strong enough, somebody like Max Stewart also work in here, or, you know.
Yeah, it really invites movement. So it's hard to say, there's a dissonance to the museum space and to the things you are expected to enact in the museum space. So this kind of stillness.
And you almost feel like it doesn't need you.
It doesn't need us at all. No. Goodbye, Anthropocene, right? For many directors, it starts with the space.
Yeah.
So you have somebody like Christoph Marthaler. Mm. Anna Wiebrock is actually the one who deciding the show, because she makes first, she thinks of a Bühnenbild, and then, so that the space is the first author.
Yeah, I mean, when we walked in and we said the thing about this claiming space, like this kind of a certain volume, a certain presence that the work has because of its scale. But even if Katharina's work is really small, I always have the sense that somehow she's unmaking and remaking space. Like whatever it is, I mean, even here, the way the step is suddenly camouflaged. Yeah. And corners disappear in some rooms, and it's really, to have that sudden alertness to a space because of the way it's been played with.
Yeah.